Quokkas are the happiest animal on the internet, and they're a strange case of how social media tourism has actually helped a species thrive. Hi, I'm Danielle Dufault, and you're watching Animal Logic. If you spend any time at all on the internet, you've likely seen the creature that has been crowned the world's happiest animal. Meet the quokka, a marsupial endemic to Australia that's about the size of a cat. Quokkas are wallabies, also known as short-tailed scrub wallabies, but quokka is much cuter. Male quokkas, fully grown, will be at most 4.5 kilos, while females will be at most 3.5. Quokkas live on an island off the western coast of Australia, with the largest population of quokkas being found on Rottnest Island. The island was named by Dutch explorers in the 17th century who equated the quokkas with large rats, and named the island Rottenest, which is derived from the Dutch word Rottenest, meaning rat nest. Quokkas live primarily in swampy territories that receive at least 1,000 millimeters of rainfall annually. Because of their rather particular territory, global warming is threatening their populations. Invasive species such as cats, foxes, and feral pigs have also proven detrimental to their numbers. Rottnest Island, however, remains a stronghold for the quokka, with around 14,000 living there, as there are no cats or foxes on the island. While not being particularly social, quokkas do live in colonies, and those on Rottnest Island are the largest, counting up to 150 members strong. Quokkas are one of the few species in which social media tourism has actually benefited them. In 2012, the hashtag QuokkaSelfie went viral, and ever since, Rottnest Island has seen a massive boom in tourism. While you would think that the rapid development of the island and influx of humans might hinder their population, it's actually had quite the opposite effect. Since the trend of quokka selfies took off, their population has thrived. Quokkas are quite docile, and it's fairly easy to get a very cute picture of or with them. Just don't get too close. Quokkas come equipped with razor-sharp teeth, and every year there are dozens of cases of people being bitten by quokkas and requiring medical attention. There's even a $300 fine for touching one. Definitely there for your own benefit. If you do visit Rottnest Island, please don't feed the quokkas. Human food is known to give them the adorably named infection, lumpy jaw, which is really anything but adorable. Quokkas have become more and more accustomed to human presence to the point of becoming a nuisance to locals, who will often find them begging for snacks in local businesses and homes. Quokkas are endangered animals, and despite their apparent friendliness, it is illegal to own one as a pet. Quokkas are herbivores and primarily nocturnal. They prefer living in forests that have burned down within the last 10 years, as that's where all the best fresh growth can be found. While they might look like the happiest animals on the planet, they do get into fights occasionally. Males will fight over females, but more commonly over the best hiding spots. When it comes to mating, females will choose their mates, and if she's not impressed, she'll employ the age-old strategy of running away. If she does find a mate she likes, she'll start grooming him, which is an invitation for him to do his thing. Quokkas gestate for just 1 month. Being marsupials, their babies, called joeys, are born severely underdeveloped and have to venture up and into mom's pouch, where they'll stay for about 6 months. In order to increase the likelihood of a successful mating routine, quokkas employ a strategy called embryonic diapause, which allows them to mate immediately after having given birth. This new embryo doesn't develop, but instead acts as a backup in case the first joey dies. If it does, the new embryo will develop, and if the first joey survives, the new embryo will disintegrate. This evolutionary development not only acts to help ensure that their genes are passed on, but occasionally, if a pregnant female quokka is cornered by a predator, she will eject her joey from her pouch, which will make a loud hissing noise, in order to distract the predator while she escapes. Not exactly mom of the year, but quokka moms aren't the only marsupials with strange parenting strategies. Koala moms feed their joeys with something called pap, which is a specialized, bacteria-rich type of, feces. Tasty. Unlike their regular feces, which are dry and pelleted, pap is a sticky liquid that acts somewhat like a probiotic, introducing bacteria into the joey's system to prepare them better for their future diet of eucalyptus leaves. As weird as that might sound, there are a lot of animals that eat poop pretty regularly. My friend Emily over at Minute Earth has done an episode about why it sometimes makes sense for certain species to eat their own feces. It's a really awesome video. If you want to know more about koala mom's strange feeding practices and a whole lot more, I'd love it if you went to her channel at youtube.com/MinuteEarth, watch her video, and be sure to subscribe. Minute Earth is a really great channel that covers everything from the rise of mesopredators to the shrinking of brains in domesticated animals to how earthworms cause major change to ecosystems around the world. It's a really great channel, and if you like animal logic, I'm sure you'll love it too. So what animal should I talk about next? Please let me know in the comments and be sure to subscribe for new episodes of Animal Logic every other week. Thanks for watching! I'd love it if you went to youtube.com/MiddleEarth. Taking off its two eyes in God.